And here's the situation we're looking at. If I take a ball, hold it in my hand, toss it upward, comes back down. Let's just think about the tossing and the going up part of the motion. We're going to look at a problem that addresses that. Let's take a look at this problem. A juggler tosses a ball straight up. Draw a motion diagram for the ball that begins at the moment the juggler's hand begins moving upward and ends at the moment the ball reaches its highest point. A motion diagram, and that's what we're going to be considering here. Motion diagram is a diagram that illustrates the important features of motion. And the important things we need to know right now is where does the motion start, where does it finish? And we're beginning at the moment the juggler's hand begins moving upward. And so that is the juggler pushing the ball upward. Then it ends, our last piece, it ends at the moment the ball reaches its highest point. Okay, that's shown us physically the important pieces of the motion. Let's think about how to diagram it. And when we draw a motion diagram, here's what we do. We start by making a series of points that represent the subsequent positions of the object. So we'll start with where the motion starts. The ball is in the juggler's hand and is going to move upward. Now we're going to make successive dots that represent the upward motion. And here's the big question. As the juggler's hand is pushing the ball upward, how does the spacing of the successive dots in the motion diagram change? We'll give you some choices. Well, as the juggler's hand is pushing the ball upward, the ball's speeding up. So the points are going to get further and further apart. And that means the successive velocity vectors are getting bigger and bigger. And that makes sense. The ball is speeding up as it's moving upwards. Now, right at this point, the ball leaves the juggler's hand. And now it's just moving upward through the air. At that point, as the ball rises to its highest point, how does the spacing of the successive dots in the motion diagram change? We'll give you some choices. Well, as the ball moves upward after having left the juggler's hand, it's slowing down. So the velocity vectors are still directed upward. The motion is still upward, but it's going slower and slower and slower. So net result is the points get closer together, the velocity vectors get shorter and shorter until the ball reaches its highest point. And that is when our problem finishes. The last step of every problem is to do an assessment and to see if it makes physical sense. And let's do that by actually making a motion diagram. With the video, we're recording this right now, so we can do this. If I take the ball, and I throw it upward like so, we can look at successive frames of the video and see if they match the motion diagram that we drew. Let's do it. So we'll play it back slowly, and in equal intervals of time, we'll put a dot that marks the position of the ball. And you can see, as the ball moves upward, the points get further and further apart. After the ball leaves the hand, the ball continues to move upward, and so the dots are going upward still. The velocity vectors are pointing upward. But they get closer and closer together until the ball reaches its highest point. And that's our assessment. That's the final step in every problem. Physics is about the world around us. We always want to make that connection as the last thing we do.